Hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson and I run covenanter.org/pamphlets. You can head over there and check out all the different pamphlets that we have to offer and even subscribe for $10 a month and you will get your very own pamphlet each and every month as we continue publishing and republishing everything that we can get our hands on. I know it's been a little while, but I've got a bunch of new pamphlets here. This pamphlet is from the month of December 2016 and it's entitled A Letter on the Civil Magistrate by John McMillan Jr. To give you an idea of what you can find within this pamphlet, I'm going to read here an excerpt from the back of the book. Today, many people think that the only requirement for legitimacy in civil magistracy is that it exists by the providence of God. This view is especially prevalent among conservative Christian groups, which view it to be their duty to submit to anyone who occupies the office of ruler. This view is often part of a worldview that calls them into closer and closer proximity to political activism. After all, the thinking is, if you don't vote, or better yet, actively campaign, then don't complain about the occupants in civil service. This, of course, presumes many things about the nature of civil magistracy. A chief belief is that whatever exists in the providence of God in civil affairs is the ordinance of God, as spoken of by the Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 13. And, we're reminded, that requires submission to the higher powers. From this misconception, Reformed Presbyterians have always begged to differ. Sometimes political involvement is prohibited to the Christian because of the constitution of the government in question. John McMillan Jr. III wrote this letter in reply to several writings by prominent seceders who in his day were trying to defend the civil magistrate based upon his simple existence in the providence of God. Mr. McMillan discusses the difference between existing according to the providence of God and existing according to the preceptive will of God. Only the latter, he argues, is the moral ordinance of God which demands obedience for conscience sake. He also discusses the difference between a heathen society, which is without the light of special revelation, especially the gospel, and those nations favored with the light of the gospel. There are things which may be born with in the former that may not be tolerated in the latter. Now, also included in this pamphlet are two short pieces relative to the subject at hand. The first is a short letter by Thomas Sproul, who's an RP professor, devoted to the question of who exactly are the higher powers spoken of by Paul. The second is a tract on the Oath of Allegiance, in which J.A. Chancellor explains why Reformed Presbyterians do not take any kinds of oaths of allegiance to immoral constitutions of government. So there you have it, A Letter on the Civil Magistrate, John McMillan Jr., and of course, two little tracks also bound right into the back there. You can check it out, pick up a copy for yourself today over at covenanter.org/pamphlets. Thank you so much for watching.